Hello everyone. Today I want to show you how to make this Japanese styled plane adjusting hammer. Now I made this thing from 1018 steel. So I was a little concerned that it might have been a little too soft. But after using it to last several weeks for adjusting my plane, and I put leather on the other side and I've been using it as a mallet, and I find that this thing works very well. So let me show you how to make this without using a forge.
The 1018 steel rod I'm using here has a diameter of 1 inch and weighs approximately 100 grams per inch. I marked the center line with a cutting wheel. Then I flattened the top a little bit to make the drilling process easier. 1018 steel is fairly easy to drill. I just have to remember to use lots of cutting fluid and make sure to drill very slowly. It dawned on me while I was drilling that I needed a fence behind the vise so that the three holes that I'm drilling are in relatively good alignment with each other, as well as with the mallet head itself. The three holes turned out better than expected. The alignment was more accurate than what I thought it needed to be. I then removed the ridges from the inside. By the time I was finished, there was probably less than a half a millimeter bump left on the inside. For the handle, I'm using a piece of scrap oak that I had left over from when I made my portable workbench. Making the tenon for the hammerhead is fairly straightforward. The only issue is that the tenon has to be rounded off at the edges so that it can fit into the hammerhead. Once I had the handle and the head fitted together, I went ahead and cleaned up the hammerhead, and I domed up one side so that one side of the hammerhead is flat and the other side is convexed. I really liked the shiny look, and I debated whether to keep it this way or not. But in the end, I decided to blacken the head. And to do that, I simply threw it into a fairly hot fire, and then I waited a while and quenched it in water. And I repeated this heating and quenching process several times until I got a consistent black surface. At this point, the hammerhead is ready to go. All I had left to do was to finish shaping the handle and prepare the tenon to receive the two wedges. The two wedges I'm using are made from ebony. Once the glue dried, I trimmed off the excess and coated the surface with a layer of linseed oil and sealed it about 24 hours later with a coat of beeswax. Well guys, I hope you enjoyed this project and see you next time.